गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। सो वी आर
मॉर्निंग मैम।
डिस्कसिंग, गुड मॉर्निंग, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट वेरी लॉग मॉड्यूल ऑफ फॉर डिफरेंट कॉम्बिनेशनल लॉजिक सर्किट। सो इन द लास्ट सेशन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हाफ एडर एंड देन फुल एडर। ओके, सो फॉर फुल एडर वी हैव सीन वेरियस different model of abstraction. That means there we have seen data flow modeling, then we have seen behavioral modeling. So we have we can have various models of abstraction in a Verilog SDL also, as like a VHDL. So here now today we are going to discuss about half subtractor. So what is half subtractor? What is mean by half subtractor?
Half subtractor is a combinational circuit which is used to subtract two bits and it gives the two outputs borrow and different.
So the half subtractor that uses two bits in two inputs. Okay, so that is let us say we have two inputs, that is A and B. Okay, so half subtractor subtracts these two bits and then give us two outputs in the form of difference and borrow. Okay, so if we look at the truth table for this, it will be like this. So as we have two inputs, so there will be four different combinations of inputs, and depending on that we will get this output. Okay, so for the difference and borrow we will get this output. So that we have discussed in the earlier unit also. So without wasting much time on this truth table, now I'll just go forward with the Boolean expression. So we have the Boolean expression for difference, that is a XOR b. Okay, and for the borrow we have a Boolean expression, that is a bar dot b, that means a bar ANDed with b. Okay, so from this truth table it is clear that we get a difference, that is a DISSS, that I have said here. So that is a XOR b, and borrow, that is a bar b. Okay, now we want to write a Verilog model for this circuit. Okay, so let us see what is the core for this circuit, that is a half subtractor. So now, as we know that whenever we are writing any program in a Verilog, so the first thing that we need to write, that is a model. Okay, so that means actually Verilog program, that we call it as a model. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do, that is we need to write a model and its name. Okay, so here we have used the keyword, that is a model, and then I have given the name for this circuit, that is a, or this program, that is a half underscore subtractor underscore two. And then in the bracket, whatever input and output ports that are available in this circuit or for this system, whatever system that we are going to write, so for that system, the different input and output ports that should be mentioned in a bracket after the module name. So I have written B, comma B, X and Y. Okay, and then semicolon. After that, now we need to mention out of these ports, what is it an input port or output port or in output? Okay, so here I have mentioned that input X, that means X is the input port. Then Y, that is again input port, so input Y semicolon, then output D semicolon, and output B semicolon. Now here type of this input port as well as output port, that is not mentioned. Okay, so by default for the input port it will take it as a wire, and for the output port it will take it as a register. Now here whatever is the port, okay, so that will just if it is a wire, then it will just read the values which are present on that wire. Okay, so here The next is that now we have the Boolean expression for both difference as well as borrow. Okay, so that means for D as well as B. So what we are going to do? We are going to assign these Boolean expression for this output. Okay, so now assign D equal to X XOR with Y. Okay, so that means here this operator, that is for a XORing purpose. So X XOR with Y, then semicolon, and then another expression that we have is a assign D that is equal to tilde X and Y. Okay, now this tilde, that is for the NOT. Okay, so that means it will perform logical NOT operation. So here this is a tilde X, so that means here we are getting X bar and Y. Okay, so here actually, as I have shown in earlier slide, that Boolean expression for borrow, that is equal to, there we used the input, that is a A and B. So we get the Boolean expression for borrow, that is a A bar B. So like that way, now if we have the input X and Y, then we will get it as a X bar and Y, X bar Y. Okay, so that is why we have shown here that it is a tilde X and Y. Okay, so now here, whenever we are using assign statement, that means we are continually assigning this result of this expression to the variable that we have. Okay, so that means we are continuously assigning result of X XOR with Y to D. Okay, so whatever changes that are present in this variable, that will be continuously reflected to that output port. Okay, so this is the expression that we have, and after that we need to end this module. So the statement, that is the end module. Okay, so this is the very long code for half subtractor. Okay, so we have just used two statements for the expressing output D as well as output borrow. Okay, so this is a very simple code for half subtractor. Okay, if anybody has doubt.
No doubt, ma'am.
Okay. The another way to express code, that is to use always at statement. Okay, that always block. But now we are regarding simple code, but even though, if you want to use that, you can. Write it as always at, and then then it be present.
Ma'am, तुमचा आवाज नाही येत आहे नीट.
तुम्ही यूज करणार आहे ते तिथे येते. Yes. And after that, you need to write this all expressions. Okay, and then end of that always block, and then end of the module. Okay, so लक्षात ठेवायचं की ऑलवेज ब्लॉक मध्ये जे काही स्टेटमेंट असतील ते सिक्वेन्शियली एक्झिक्युट होतात. सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट दॅट इन अ ऑलवेज ब्लॉक दॅट आर एक्झिक्युटेड सिक्वेन्शियली, वाईल हियर दीज आर नॉट, दीज कॅन बी एक्झिक्युटेड कंकरंटली ऑल्सो. ओके, सो दिस इज द दिस इज द Verilog code for half subtractor. Now let us discuss about full subtractor. Now what is full subtractor?
Full subtractor is a combinational circuit which used to subtract 3 bits, and it gives the output the difference and borrow.
Yes, so it is a combinational circuit which has 3 inputs, that is the A, B, and B, that is the input borrow. Okay, and it gives two outputs, that is a difference and the output borrow. So truth table for this full subtractor is shown over here. So you can see here, depending on the various input combinations, we get difference and borrow, okay, these two outputs. So here, if we look for the Boolean expression for difference, then it is A XORed with B XORed with B in. And output borrow, that is equal to A bar ANDed with B XOR B in plus B ANDed with B in. Okay, so this is the Boolean expressions for the outputs of this full subtractor. Okay, so now we are going to write again a data flow modeling Verilog code for this full subtractor. Okay, so can anybody tell me how to write this code? What will be the first statement? काय करणार आहे पहिलं स्टेटमेंट काय असेल
मॉड्यूल
येस मॉड्यूल देन मॉड्यूल मॉड्यूल नेम अँड देन व्हॉट एव्हर आर द पोर्ट्स दॅट आर प्रेझेंट इन दिस सर्किट ओके सो नाऊ यू कॅन सी हिअर नाऊ द इन अ अर्लियर प्रोग्राम व्हॉट वी डिड हिअर we have just written the ports that are present, and after that we declare what type of port it is. Okay, but you can directly go write it in a first statement only, where you are declaring the name of that module. So here what is done, module, then full subtractor, then we have the output ports that are output D comma B, okay, and then input ports that are X comma Y comma B. Okay, so that means in a program you can write it in this way, or you can go with the another way, that is whatever you feel simple that you can adopt. Okay, so here you can write it as a first, in the first line you can write module, then module name, whatever name that you want to give. Okay, then after that all the ports that are present in the that circuit. Okay, so here you can write it as a D comma B comma X comma Y comma B in, okay, and then semicolon, and after that you can write it as a input X, then input Y, input B in, then output D and output B. After all each of these sentences syntaxes, there should be semicolon. Okay, so this is the way. So I have shown it in both the way, so whatever you feel comfortable with that you can write it in. So meaning of both these is the same. Then after that, okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to assign D is equal to X XORed with Y XORed with B, because our Boolean expression for D is the XORing of all these three inputs. So difference, that is equal to X XORed with Y XORed with B. Okay, always you have to remember which operator that we are using. Okay, so for XORing, what is the operator or the symbol that we have used, that you have to remember. So this is the exponential mark, that is for the XORing purpose. Okay, so this is the first output that we have assigned, and another output, that is a B, which is equal to X bar. Okay, so for that we have used tilde X. Okay, then after that we have AND it with the second output and the input borrow. So that means here what we have done, Y XORed with B, and then this is ANDed with a X bar. Okay, and after that ORing operation. So OR, for this it symbol used is a vertical bar, and then Y AND with B, that is the input borrow. So this is the statement for output borrow. Okay, so we are assigning result of this expression to B and then end of this model. Okay, so this is the Verilog code for full subtractor. Okay, so that means if you know the circuit, what will be the Boolean expression for the output of that circuit, then it is very easy to write a Verilog code for that circuit. Okay, so data flow modeling, that is a very easy for in this using this Verilog HDL. Okay, so just remember all these circuits. Now in a second unit as well as in a third unit, we are going to have code for same circuits. Okay, that means once you have good knowledge regarding half adder, half subtractor, full adder, full subtractor, then encoder, decoder, multiplexer, demultiplexer, it will be very easy to write code in any one of these languages. Okay, VHDL asu det kiwa Verilog asu det, tumhala ya circuit cha output kay ahe he perfectly maithi asel, so then it is very easy to write code. So just remember all the Boolean expression and truth table for all these circuits, and that you have studied in the second year itself. So that means it is very easy to write this code. Okay, so this is the full subtractor. Now the next circuit that we are going to discuss, that is a encoder. So what is encoder? What is encoder?
Encoder is a combinational circuit which encode the input.
The encoder, that is a combinational circuit that encodes the input. Okay, so that means it converts binary information in the form of 2^n input lines into n output lines. Okay, so suppose we have 8 input lines, then we get output. That is, how many lines output we will get?
3
output lines. Okay, so we are going to check for this. It has 3 encoder here. Now always remember that for a simple encoder, only one input line will be active at a time. So we are assuming that, and then we are going to see the Verilog code for this circuit. So this is the symbol of it has 3 encoder. So we have 8 input lines and 3 output lines. Okay, so that means for this circuit we will have 8 input ports and 3 output ports. So this is the truth table for encoder. So we are, as I earlier said, that we are assuming that only one input will be active at a time, and depending on that we will get the output. So now when D0 bit is active, so we will get the output, that is all these three outputs, that is 0 0 0. When D1 is active, we will get output, that is 0 0 1. And in the same way, when D7 is active, we will get output, that is 1 1 1. Okay, so at that time all other outputs that will not be in active, so that means it will be at a 0 logic level. Okay, so if we write a Boolean expression for this output, so we will get x is equal to d4 plus d5 plus d6 plus d7. Okay, and then for y we will get this expression, that is d2 plus d3 plus d4 plus 6 d7. Okay, and then for z it will be d1 plus d3 plus d5 plus d7. That means all these outputs that will be ORing of all the 4 inputs. Okay, so depending on these respective 4 inputs, we will get out ORing of these 4 inputs, we will get output. Okay, so as I earlier said, that there will be only one input that will be active at a time. So let us now go for the Verilog code for this circuit. Okay, so the first line in this code, that will be module declaration. Okay, so the name of module. So here module, I'll have the name of this module as an encoder and all the ports that are available in this circuit. Okay, so I have 8 input ports and 3 output ports. So I have declared all these ports in this bracket. So that is a D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, and D7. And then output ports, that is a A, B, and C, bracket complete and semicolon. Then after that, I have input ports that are input D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, and D7. Okay. So all these ports that are separated with the commas. Remember that whenever you are writing ports in a single line, that time you have to separate these ports with a semicolon. So input and all these ports after, and after end of the statement, there will be semicolon. Then output ports that are A, B, C, all are separated with the commas and end will be semicolon. Okay. Now, okay. So what is A output? A output, that is nothing but ORing of D4, D5, D6 and D7. Okay. Actually, in the earlier diagram, I have taken it as a X, Y, Z. Okay. So you can have that also names. Okay, naming is not compulsory that you should be have these names only. I can use X, Y, Z also. So if I have taken it as a X, then X is equal to D4 plus D5 plus D6 plus D7. Okay. So you can have, okay, inbuilt function of which is present in a Verilog, that is a OR. Okay. So here OR and in the bracket, that is a A, D4, D5, D6 and D7 and then end of the bracket semicolon. Now what is meaning of this? This is the A is the output which is nothing but ORing of all the remaining operands that are present here. Okay. So that means it is the ORing of all these remaining ports. So the first will show or first will give us the output and then others are the input to this. So here we will have the A that is equal to ORing of D4, D5, D6 and D7. Okay. Then B is equal to, now here, ORing of D2, D3, D6 and D7. So the syntax that is used to get this output, that is a OR in the bracket B, D2, D3, D6 and D7 and the bracket complete and semicolon. Okay. So remember that this is a inbuilt function that is present in the Verilog which will do ORing operation on the inputs. Okay. So here the first variable that is shown in the bracket, that will be the output and remaining that are the inputs. Okay. Then third, that is a OR C, D1, D3, D5, D7 and then end of the statement, so semicolon. Okay, so in this way you will get all these three outputs A, B and C. Okay, and then end of this module, that is a, for that we will have the keyword, that is the end module. Now always remember that after end module, there is no semicolon or end statement in every wherever you are using end, there will not be semicolon after that. So the next circuit that we are going to discuss, that is a decoder. So what will be decoder? What is decoder? What is decoder?
Decoder is a combinational circuit which is used to decode the encoded data.
That means a decoder that does exactly work exactly opposite to that of the encoder. So it is a combinational circuit that converts n line input into 2 raised to n lines of output. Okay. So that means if we have 3 input lines, we will get 8 output lines. Okay. So let us take one example of a 3 raised to 8 line decoder. Okay. So this is the truth table for this 3 to 8 decoder. Here we have 3 input lines and we have 8 output lines. Okay, so depending on the input, we will get the respective output line that will be active. Okay, so for all these 3 inputs are suppose 0, 0, 0, then they will have only, now remember again in this circuit that only one output will be active at a time. So whenever we have the inputs, that is a 0, 0, 0, D0 line will be active. For 0, 0, 1, D1 line will be active. For 0, 1, 0, D2. For 0, 1, 1, D3 line will be active. And for 1, 0, 1, D5 line. And for 1, 1, 0, D6. And 1, 1, 1, D7 line will be active. Okay. So for particular input combination, always there will be only one output line that will be active. All other will be at a logic zero level. So if we write a Boolean expression for each of this output, then we will get D0 that is equal to X bar, Y bar, Z bar. D1 that is equal to X bar, Y bar, Z. D2 that is equal to X bar, Y, Z bar. D3 X bar, Y, Z. D4 X, Y bar, Z bar. D5 X, Y bar, Z. D6 that is X, Y, Z bar. And D7 that is X, Y and Z. Okay. So this is the Boolean expressions for each of these output lines. Now, is it possible for you to write a Verilog code for this circuit? So try to write it and then we will correct it. So if there is any wrong. Okay, so try to write the code for this circuit. We are using data flow modeling. That means we are going to use Boolean expression for assigning output, okay? I hope you have tried. So let us discuss about this code. So what will be the first line in this code?
Module decoder into bracket XYZ D0 to D7 bracket complete semicolon.
Yes. So module then decoder. Okay. So I have written all the outputs first and after that input. Okay. So it is not necessary to write it in a sequential order only. You can write it anyhow. But it is needed that all the input as well as output ports that must be present in that bracket. Okay, so A, B, C, then d0 d1 d2 d3 d3 d4 d5 d6 and d7. Okay, so make sure that all the ports that are included in this statement. Then after that, we have the input ports that are A, comma B, comma C. Okay. Then after that, we have the output ports that is a D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D6, D7. Okay. And now, what will be the next line for this?
And into bracket D0 comma X bar comma
Square.
Y bar comma Z bar bracket complete semicolon.
Yes, D0 that will be equal to as we are going to assign. Okay, so now as we are not going to use always block, so we are going to assign each of this expression as a output. Okay, so assign D0 that is equal to not A, so that means we are going to use operator that is a tilde and tilde B and tilde C. That means it will be equal to A bar, B bar, C bar. Okay, then okay, so there should be semicolon. Okay, I have used assign statement only once. Okay, so you can use assign statement only once, and then all these outputs that are written separated by commas. Okay, or otherwise, what you can do, you can have separate assignment statements and end each of these statements with a semicolon. Okay, so here I have used assign only once and separated all these outputs with a commas. So D1 that is equal to again A bar. So for A bar tilde A and for B bar tilde B and C. Okay, then comma D2. Okay, so check for this D3, D4, D5, D6 and D7. Okay, and then after that, as here this statement is ended, then there will be a semicolon. Okay, so म्हणजे इथे काय केलं, एकदाच असाइन स्टेटमेंट यूज केलं आणि त्याच्यानंतर जेवढे आउटपुट आहेत त्यांचे एक्सप्रेशन जे काही आहेत ते काय केले, कॉमाने सेपरेट केलेत, आणि जेव्हा एंड होईल स्टेटमेंट कम्प्लिटली देन वी हॅव यूज अ सेमिकोलन अँड देन इट इज अ एंड ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हेरी लॉग कोड फॉर डिकोडर, 3SQH डिकोडर. लक्षात आलंय सगळ्यांचं हे काय केलं?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt about this circuit?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so let us go
Question
further.
nahi hai.
Now we are going to
Question
discuss
nahi
with
hai.
the one more circuit, that is the multiplexer. So what is multiplexer now?
Multiplexer is a combinational circuit which converts the many into one.
Many into one. Okay, so for multiplexer we need to have certain select lines. Depending on the that input on that select line, we will have respective input at the output present. Okay, so here we are going to check for the 4:1
Yeah, ma'am.
multiplexer. Okay, so now depending on the inputs, okay, so if suppose we have 2 raised to n number of inputs, then there will be n number of select lines that will be present for that multiplexer. Okay, so these select lines that are also called as a data selector. So here as we are going to discuss about 4:1 multiplexer, so it
Madam,
will have
please disconnect it.
four. Saivi, please mute yourself, or you want to say something?
मैडम
मैम
स्क्रीन
स्क्रीन
डिसेबल
दिसत
नहीं
नाही
है, स्क्रीन
आहे.
दिसत
ओके ओके. वेट फॉर फ्यू मिनट. ओके नाउ इज इट विजिबल? यस
यस
मैम.
यस मैम.
ओके अर्लियर स्लाइड वॉज विजिबल टू यू?
यस
यस. दिस कोड वॉज विजिबल टू यू ऑल?
हाँ मैम.
So let us continue with the next circuit, that is the multiplexer. So as I said, multiplexer that converts multiple line input into a single line input depending on the select lines that are present. The particular input will be available at the output. So suppose we have 2 raised to n number of input lines, then we require n number of select lines so as to get particular data transferred at the output line. Okay. So as we are going to discuss about 4:1 multiplexer, so it has 4 inputs. Okay. So that means 2:2 inputs. So here, for this multiplexer, we require 2 select lines, which are also called as a data selector. And depending on this input present at this select line, we will get the particular output transferred at the output line. Okay, so that means if this is a 0 0, select lines that are 0 0, a output will be present at a input that will be present at the output. Okay, so this is the truth table for this circuit. Okay, so here when both these inputs are 0 0, z will be equal to a. When it is equal to 0 1, its output will be b. When it is a 1 0, output will be C, and 1 1, output will be D. Okay, so this is the truth table for multiplexer. Now we are going to discuss about the Verilog code. So the first we are going to declare the module name. So module M41. Okay, so 4:1 multiplexer. So I have used the name for this multiplexer, that is the M41, and then the first port, that is the A port, which is the input port. Then second port, that is the B, which is again a input port. Then C, that is the input, D input. Then S0 and S1, these are also input ports. So and out is the output. So these are the ports which are available in the multiplexer. So now what we are going to do, we are going to assign, okay, out is equal to S1 question mark, S0 question mark, D colon C colon S0 colon, question mark, B colon A, and end of the bracket and semicolon. Okay. So that means actually what we are going to perform here, we are using a conditional statement. Okay. So as we have seen earlier that in a conditional expression, what we are doing, we are using a question mark for the condition. So here it will check for the S1 condition. Okay, if it is true, then it will perform the first expression which is present, and if it is false, it will go for the second expression. Okay, so that means it will check here, it is the condition that is given. If it S1 is true, then it will go for the checking of the condition for the expression S0. Okay. Now again, here there is a one more condition. Okay. So it will check for whether S0 is true or false. Okay. If it is true, then it will give us the output that is equal to B. Okay. Or if it is false, then it will be output will be equal to C. Now, if the total condition, that means S1 is not equal to 1, so this condition is false, then it will go for this expression. Okay. Here we have the expression that is a S0. Okay. Again, we have used one more condition, that is whether S0 is true or false. So that means whether S0 is equal to 1 or it is equal to 0. If it is equal to 1, then output will be equal to B. And if it is equal to 0, then output will be equal to A. Okay. So that means actually here, whenever we are going to check S1 is true or false, means S1 काय करणार आहे आपण 1 1 0 घेणार आहे. आता जर माझं S1 1 आहे, तर मी काय करणार आहे, या कंडिशनला जाणार आहे. जर माझं एस वन झिरो असतं तर मी दुसऱ्या एक्सप्रेशनसाठी जाईल. आता माझं एस वन वन आहे म्हणजे मी काय चेक करेन, एस झिरो काय आहे हे चेक करणार आहे. आता एस झिरो झिरो किंवा वन या दोन कंडिशन मधलं काही असेल, ओके. सो आय विल चेक फॉर दिस कंडिशन. इफ एस झिरो इज इक्वल टू वन, दॅट मीन्स दिस कंडिशन इज ट्रू, देन आय विल गो फॉर असायनिंग आउटपुट दॅट इज इक्वल टू डी. म्हणजेच काय होणार आहे, माझं एस झिरो एस वन वन आहे, एस झिरो पण वन आहे, तर माझं आउटपुट काय असेल, डी असेल. आता दुसरी कंडिशन काय येणार आहे, माझं एस वन वन आहे पण माझी ही कंडिशन फॉल्स आहे, म्हणजे एस झिरो झिरो आहे, देन माय आउटपुट विल बी सी. ओके, सो दॅट मीन्स फॉर वन वन आय विल गेट आउटपुट इक्वल टू डी, फॉर वन झिरो आय विल गेट आउटपुट दॅट इज इक्वल टू सी. नाऊ सपोज दिस एस वन इज इक्वल टू झिरो, दॅट मीन्स ऍक्च्युली दिस कंडिशन इज फॉल्स. सो एस वन इज झिरो, देन आय विल नॉट गो फॉर दिस एक्सप्रेशन, आय विल गो फॉर द एक्सप्रेशन विच इज आफ्टर दिस कोलन. ओके, सो नाऊ हियर देर इज वन मोअर कंडिशन, इट इज गोइंग टू चेक वॉट इज द लॉजिक लेवल फॉर एस झिरो. ओके, सो नाऊ एस वन इज झिरो, इफ एस झिरो इज वन देन इट विल हॅव द व्हॅल्यू, आउटपुट विल हॅव द व्हॅल्यू दॅट इज इक्वल टू बी. ओके, ऑर अदरवाईज इफ एस वन इज झिरो अँड एस झिरो इज ऑल्सो झिरो, इट विल गिव्ह द आउटपुट दॅट इज इक्वल टू ए. ओके, सो दॅट मीन्स ऑल द लॉजिक फॉर दिस सर्किट दॅट वी हॅव कंबाइंड इन अ सिंगल सेंटेन्स अँड देन वी आर गेटिंग द आउटपुट फॉर दिस मल्टीप्लेक्सर. ओके, एव्हरीबडी अंडरस्टूड दिस?
यस मॅम.
येस, सो नाऊ द एंड ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल अँड दिस इज द एंड मॉड्यूल. ओके, वेरी लॉग कोड फॉर दिस मल्टीप्लेक्सर. नाऊ कॅन एनी ऑल ऑफ यू कॅन राईट वेरी लॉग कोड फॉर टू एस टू वन वन मल्टीप्लेक्सर? व्हेरी सिम्पल.
आता लगेच लिहू दे मॅम.
ओके, यू कॅन राईट इट ॲज अ होमवर्क अँड देन यू कॅन सेंड इट टू मी. ओके, सो दिस इज द मल्टीप्लेक्सर. देन नेक्स्ट सर्किट दॅट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दॅट इज अ डी मल्टीप्लेक्सर. नाउ व्हॉट इज डी मल्टीप्लेक्सर?
इट इज ऑल्सो अ कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट विच कन्वर्ट वन इंटू मेनी.
Which converts one into many. So demultiplexer that selects one output from the multiple output lines, okay, and fetch the single input through select lines. So it consists of one input and two select lines and four outputs for 1s2 4 demultiplexer. The output lines that are controlled by this selection line. So here we have this truth table for 1s2 4 demultiplexer. So whenever both these select lines that are 0 0, then at that time A output will be active. Whenever so that means whatever is in output that is present at the input line, that will be available at A. Okay, if select lines are 0 1, then input will be available at B. Whenever 1 0 select lines are 1 0, output will be available at C, and for 1 1 input will be available at D. Okay, so now we are going to write a Verilog code for this circuit. So the first statement in this code, that is the declaring name of this module and then all the ports that are present in this circuit. Okay, so the module name that I have given as a demultiplexer 1_4. Okay, so module demultiplexer 1_4 and then in the bracket all the ports that are available. So it is a D in, then X, comma Y, comma A, comma B, comma C, and comma D. Okay, So x and y that I have stated as a select line, d in is the input, and a, b, c, d, these are the outputs. Okay, so output a, output b, output c, output d, then input d in, input x, input y. Okay, so this is the declaration of this, all these input as well as output posts. Now always remember that here I have not mentioned type of these input ports. Okay, so whenever it is the input port and if type is not mentioned, it will by default take it as a wire, and if it is the output port, then it will by default take it as a register. Now what will be expression for a output a? So a, that is nothing but d in and x bar and y bar. For that we will have the expression, that is d in and ampersand in the bracket, it is a tilde x, so that is meaning x bar, and tilde y, so that is a y bar. Okay, so then what will be b? What will be expression for b? I will show you truth table and then tell me what will be expression for B. Just look at the truth table.
D in into and into bracket not of x and y.
Yes. Okay, so here you will get b, that assign b equal to d in and x bar, so tilde x and y. Okay, what will be c? Now c will be equal to
d in and x and not of y.
Yes. So it will be d in and x and y bar. And then d will be equal to
c d in and x and y.
D will be equal to d in and x and y. Okay. So this is, these are the expressions for all these outputs, and then after that there will be end of this module. Okay, so as we have expressed all these expressions for the output, so there will be end of this module. So this is the Verilog code for 1s to 4 demultiplexer. Okay, and now we are going to check for the one more circuit, that is the comparator. Now what is comparator?
Comparator is a combinational circuit which is used to compare.
It is a combinational circuit which compares two values, okay, and then gives the result in terms of whether suppose we have two inputs, then it will give the result in terms of a, whether a is greater than b, or whether a is less than b, or it is equal to b. Okay, so that means we have three outputs. One is a greater than b, a less than b, or a equal to b. Okay, always only one in output will be active, other outputs will be at a logic zero. कुठलं तरी एकच आउटपुट हे हाय असेल, बाकीचे सगळे काय असणार आहे? zero state. Okay, so that is the comparator circuit. So here, this is the block diagram or symbol of this comparator. We have two inputs, A and B, and then we have three outputs, that is less than, greater than, and equal to. Okay, so we'll see Verilog code for this circuit. So the first statement that will be for the comparator, the first statement that will be name of the module. Okay, so module comparator, and in the bracket all the ports that are present. Okay, now here I have not used enable directly. I'm going for the inputs as in the outputs. Okay, not going to enable this. That means enable pin is not used here. So the ports that are A and B, these are the inputs, and outputs that is a greater than, less than, and equal. So GT, LT, and EQ, these are the output ports. So now let us say that we are going to check for the 4-bit numbers. Okay, so here we need to specify this what is the size of that ports. Okay, so here we have input in the square bracket 3:0a,b. That means A and B are the four. These are the registers GT, LT, and E. All are the output registers. Here, always block is used. Okay, so always at A and B. It means whenever there is a change in this input port A and B, what is after that? So beginning of this always block begin, and here if okay, so suppose A is B, what this means GT and that case EQ will be equal to 0 and L be equal to 0. End of this. Now we are going to check for whether A is less than B. Okay, so if A is less than B, then again B to 0 is that case equal to 0 and A equal to 1. Okay, then after that else begin GT will be equal to 0. If both these conditions are false, then GT will be equal to 0. If you will and T equal to 0 in the end of always block and end of model. Okay, so here we have this statement and then the always block and end of the model. Okay, so this is the comparator circuit. Here we have comparing 4-bit input. So this is the 4-bit comparator circuit. So directly we have stated all these statements. Okay, for each of output that we have given is a very long code for comparator. Anybody has doubt about? In other languages, when we use each statement, we don't use begin and end for this condition. We begin and end statement, okay? And in between that, whatever operations that we need to perform, that are stated. So, after whether it is true, which stated because actually we are going to implement hardware design. This whatever program we are going to implement in hardware, and that what is the state that we are having? That needs to be original. And then here, these statements are executed sequentially. So that sequence should be maintained for that we are having. This begin state in the loop. Okay, so this then the sequence. So this is the comparator code. So if you have any doubt, just ask. Here we have ended our third unit, but if you have doubts, you can ask me.
No doubt, ma'am.
I will stop it for today. We will discuss in the next session tomorrow. So you leave this meeting.